Hello, Fontana. It's Mayor Mundy with Mayor Aquanetta Warren. It's that time again. You know, last week, I had a chance to talk to some great people in South Fontana. We shared ideas and discussed viewpoints and had a great productive dialogue. This is the type of engagement and work that helped move Fontana forward. Believe me when I say that, I'm listening to you. And I always encourage and invite residents to sit down and have a two-way conversation with me. Let's talk, Fontana. As you know, I'm committed to keeping everyone as informed as possible. This week, I have several amazing announcements, all of which occurred just last week. First, we completed the installation of an all-way stop at the intersection of State Route 210 and Beach Avenue. The stop ahead signs and pavement markings are on Beach Avenue were also included in that installation. Changeable message signs and stop sign flashers have been temporarily installed to alert drivers. Next, the County of San Bernardino Board of Supervisors announced that tomorrow, June 15th, it will fully reopen its economy, eliminating various restrictions and saying goodbye to the color-coded county tier system. I'm so excited, and I know you are too. Restaurants, bars, retail stores, theaters, hotels, and entertainment centers may return to usual operation, meaning no capacity limitations and no requirements for social distancing. All of California's restrictions on travel outside the state will be lifted, and the state says it is not considering creating a vaccine passport. There was a lot of discussion regarding the mask situation, but it has been determined that fully vaccinated people can resume activities without wearing a mask or physically distancing, except where required by federal, state, and local laws. Private businesses may choose to continue requiring facial coverings. This means while fully vaccinated, individuals won't need to wear face coverings in most indoor and outdoor settings. They will still be required to wear a mask on planes, buses, trains, airports, and transportation stations. Other places where vaccinated people will still need to wear masks include healthcare settings, prisons, homeless shelters, and schools. Cal OSHA is still deciding what the mask rules will be for workplaces in the state. We will let you know when we have more information. Also, anyone is free to wear a mask anytime they'd like, especially around children and others who are vulnerable. Unvaccinated or partially vaccinated individuals will still be required to wear facial coverings outside of their home and can only take off their mask in public when they're outside and can maintain 6 feet of distance with others. Here is the next announcement. The City Council and I approved the budget for fiscal year 21-22 and fiscal year 22-23. Approving a two-year budget allows us to shift to longer-term thinking and will save significant staff time. But here's the most important part. The budget approval included allocating the remaining funding needed for the South Fontana Sports Park and the South Fontana Dog Park. Yes, you heard me right. We now have the remaining money needed to fund both parks. But wait, there's more. Through the assistance of our congressional partners, Norma Torres and Pete Aguilar, the Malaga Bridge Project has been included in the American Jobs Plan, Transportation and Infrastructure Package. That means if it clears the Senate and is approved, we will be allocated $15 million for this project. The allocation will not only preserve our historic bridge but remove traffic obstructions and provide critical linkages in our community. I am so grateful for the support of our congressional partners and staff in moving this project forward. This last item is a reminder instead of an announcement. We are still looking for your input on the housing element update draft document. Your feedback will be gathered through an online survey. All the information can be found on the website at www.fontana.org/housing element. Please don't wait. The survey closes on June 24th. Now, let's get to the Did You Know segment. Did you know that our new city budget earmarks $7 million to our roads and sidewalks? In Fontana, maintaining and enhancing our infrastructure is a priority. The council and I fully understand that investments in transportation and infrastructure is an investment in improving our quality of life. Now on to the best part of Mayor Mondays, your questions. Let's see. First question, can we focus on getting better schools in Fontana? When will this be addressed? Great question, and something that is always on my mind. I have established a collaborative called the Mayor's Education Coalition. The coalition is an intentional network of schools, businesses, and local leaders whose purpose is to help prepare Fontana students for current and future job and career opportunities. Together, we are working to better educate and provide educational opportunities for our students. Now that I think about it, the timing of this question is perfect. During the budget presentation this past Tuesday, we clarified that most of the property tax dollars collected by the city are allocated to the Fontana Unified School District. Please know we are working diligently and cooperatively to ensure that our students are skilled, trained, and ready for the workforce. Next question. At one time, Fontana was considered the 15th safest city in the nation. What is being done to get us back there? Our police department is working hard to ensure the safety and well-being of the city. In 2020, we hired 22 new officers. We continue to recruit officers and develop and implement new programs to protect all the residents of Fontana. I want to take a quick minute to share my gratitude to both Police Chief Green and Assistant Fire Chief Jeff Birchfield for their hard work in implementing the Community Outreach and Support Team we're calling COAST. This program will formally launch in early July. Its purpose is to provide support to homeless and those experiencing a crisis. Most encounters between people in crisis or the homeless and law enforcement do not involve criminal activity. Yet, officers are routinely called because there's no one else to respond. The COAST, or that team, will assist with these calls. We will keep you posted on the program. Next question. Will we be getting any businesses that are family friendly? We need more things to do here, such as sit-down restaurants, shopping malls, bowling, etc. I agree with you. Our goal is to bring the amenities and shopping that our residents want. We are working to do just that. Next question. Is there anything in plans for the traffic division on Sierra Avenue? Specifically, the freeway bridge coming from south to north and merging of vehicles coming out of the freeway east to west on Valley. There is nothing in the works right now. This intersection was fully improved back in the early 2000s. It just happens to be the site of a few high-density businesses. Last question. Why don't all park playgrounds have a canopy? Is it possible to get additional canopies? Keep in mind a few older park playgrounds in Fontana that don't have shade were established when the requirement wasn't necessary. However, we have now established a requirement that all new playgrounds built in the city have integrated shade components included as part of the play structures. In 2016, we installed large shade canopies at Bill Martin and the Jack Bullock Park using grant funding provided by the state of California through their housing-related parks program. The cost to build these shade structures at the time was $90,000 for each park. Unfortunately, there have not been any other similar grant funding opportunities provided since then. We are continuing to look for ways to provide more shade for our city's park playgrounds. That's all the questions I have for this week. For the most part, this is all the up-to-date Fontana information. Please be sure to subscribe to our newsletter or follow us on social media. Thank you for joining me today, and I look forward to answering your questions during the next Mayor Monday. Keep those questions and comments coming. You can do that by sending them to us through social media or emailing pio@fontana.org. Don't forget, Fontana together moves Fontana forward. Until next time, Fontana, have a great week.